If I trap some gas in a container with the lid closed, the gas particles will collide into the walls of the container. The particles will exert a force on the walls. And since pressure is force over area, we can also say that the gas exerts a pressure inside of the container. What if I now dump the gas into a larger container? Does that make a difference to the pressure? The number of gas particles remain the same as before, but the container is now much more spacious so that the gas particles need to travel a further distance before colliding with the walls. This means that there are fewer collisions in a given time. There will be a smaller total force acting on the walls of the container. And since pressure is force over area, decreasing force also decreases pressure. But what if I now shrink the container, keeping the amounts of gas the same? Pressure now increases because the particles can collide more frequently. Let's take some readings with these three containers side by side. This container has a volume of 2 cubic meters, and using my pressure gauge, I measure a pressure of 500 pascals. This container has a volume of 1 cubic meter, and the gas exerts a pressure of 1,000 pascals. The volume of this container is 0.5 of a cubic meter, and pressure is 2,000 pascals. I'm going to add an extra column here and say that this column here is for multiplying volume by the corresponding pressure. So if I take each row and multiply them together, I get 1,000 for all of them. This is not a coincidence. Boyle's law tells us that for a fixed amount of gas and a constant temperature, the pressure multiplied by volume is always constant. So pressure times volume is equal to a constant. You can also write it like this. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. These are the initial pressure and initial volume. On the right hand side, this is the pressure of the same gas, but that is after you've changed the volume of the container to this new volume. Let's try a question with this equation. A gas in a ball has a volume of 25 centimeters cubed and a pressure of 100,000 pascals. The ball is squashed into a volume of 4 centimeters cubed without a change in temperature. What is the new pressure? Initial pressure is 100,000 pascals, and initial volume is 25 centimeters cubed. Final volume is 4 centimeters cubed, and we want to find the final pressure. P1 V1 is P2 V2. Making our substitutions, we now get this. We now need to make P2 the subject, because that's what we want to find. So to bring this to the other side, we need to divide. So the pressure of the ball after it's been squashed is 625,000 pascals. Thanks for watching my video, and if you think you learned something from it, be sure to subscribe.